friends, today you are going to learn with Praveen to cover the chapter Things Around Us. Things around us can be broadly classified into two types. These are living things and non-living things. How we can differentiate between living things and non-living things? Living things have some characteristics which non-living things do not have. So friends, what are these characteristics? First characteristic we have is structural organization. The bodies of all the living organism is made up of the smallest living structure called up the cells. And when this group of cells doing a particular work, then it is said to be a tissue. And when the groups of tissues doing a particular work, they form up a organ. And when these organs of group of organs come together doing a particular work, they form organ system. And when many organs systems come together and doing a life process works, just like digestion, respiration, they form about a complete individual, you and me. We can classify the organism based on the number of cells they have. If they have one cell, then we call it as a unicellular. And when they have more than one, then we call this as a multicellular. Then we have is a moment. All human beings or the all the living things move. There are mainly two types of movements. One is internal and another is external. External is movement which we can see. Just like human being moving, the leaves of the tree moving. Then another we have is an internal movement in which just I eat up a food. This food will be again go to my stomach, which is an internal movement of my muscles pushing the food. Just like the trees also are living things, so it should follow also movement. Movement it follows an internal movement. The transpiration of water and minerals from the root to their leaves. This is a example of the movement in the trees. Then we have the response to stimuli. What is a stimuli? A stimuli is a sudden change or an immediate change in our environment that makes the organism do an activity. So what is this activity? I tell you with an example. If you take up a pot, hot pot, and touch your hand on it, this which heat the pot has is called a stimuli, and this I immediately proceed my hand backward, this is my response. This trees also give a response to me, just as you can see in a do not touch me plant. When you touch the leaves of the plant, it closes its leaves. Or when you put a fire under a tree, the leaves of tree started moving here and there. Then we have is growth and development. The tree sapling grows into a tree. A little baby grows into an adult. All the living things grow and develop themselves. This using the process of growth and development. Next, we have is extinction. What is extinction? The living things get rid of their waste using this process. If we do not get rid of our waste, then these waste can word is exhale. And these two processes are called breathing. Plants also breathe. How they breathe? We take in oxygen, which is produced by a tree, and they have the noses in the leaves. So they have some small parts called stomata. This is used for the exchange of gases. Then we have is a reproduction. The process of making copy of their own is called a reproduction. Then how human beings reproduce? They give birth to their young ones or laid egg. And in trees, this is performed by the pollination, or the seed is formed for the growth of a baby plant. Then we have the nutrition. All animals or all living things need food. They intake the food using the process of called nutrition. How the trees, we know that we eat food. Then how does the trees take food? They have their roots downward. They take in water from these carbon dioxide from the stomata, and the sun's sunlight fall on these stomata and absorb, and this way the trees make their own food by the process of photosynthesis. But that's why they are called heterotrophs. Hetero means alto, means they can produce their our own food. And we eat the food already produced by the trees. So we are called autotrophs. Then we have is a lifespan and length. An organism takes birth, growth, respire, reproduction, and then at the last dies. Then this process is called a life cycle or a lifespan. Just for an example, a hen lays a egg and it hatches, and the chick came out, and then this chick became a hen. So this process goes again and again. So this is a life cycle. Then we have is an environment. So friends, what is an environment? The environment is all the things that surround us and affect the health or the growth and development of a living organism is called the environment. This environment can be divided into two parts. This is biotic and abiotic. Biotic means all living. So the living comes plants, animals, scavengers, and decomposer. A plant can make their own food using a process of photosynthesis. Plants make their own food using a process of photosynthesis. Animals take the food already produced by the plants. And these already produced by a plant. So they are called autotrophs. Then we have the scavengers and decomposer. Scavengers are the animals which feed on the remains, dead body parts of an animal. And decomposers are the tiny organisms which feed on the remains of a dead animal to convert into the simpler substances and mix into the soil. Now, interaction between among the biotic components. How it is happening? The plant produces food and it is eaten by a omnivorous, which is again a secondary consumers. Then it is when that organism dies, it is feed on a scavenger or decomposer to again mix that nutrition to this soil, and again a new planter grows in it. So this whole process is called a nutrition cycle. Then we have is an abiotic component. What are the abiotic components? Abiotic components are that non-living things which affect the growth and development of a biotic components. These are first life. You may suppose that what happens if there were no life? Like plants could not produce food and we could not get enough heat to generate our body normal body temperature. It would be so cool on our earth. Then we have the temperature. What is the temperature? The hotness of the cold, or how something cold or hot it is called a temperature. We have the different temperatures on the earth to the life or exist. Just between on the equator we have is a very hot climate. So there is very hot climate, some trees can only. Then between the equator and the tropic of Cancer and tropic of Capricorn, we have a moderate climate, and between Arctic Circle and North Pole and South Pole, we have a very extreme cold. Then we have is air. Air is very important because we breathe in oxygen. Without it, we would be not alive. And plants take in carbon dioxide in the process of photosynthesis. They also take the oxygen at the night while in the doing a process of respiration. Then we have is water. Water is essential for all the organisms found on our earth. Then soil. Soil is this floor that we stretch. It has different parts. This topmost part, which is rich in nutrition, is called a humus. And then this part is called the second most layer, which is have some nutrition and is very powdered. Soil is very powdered. This is called upper top soil. Then we have is a parent soil, and then we have is a background. So friends, what we learned today in our chapter? We learned about the characteristics. Characteristics, what are these characteristics? Structure, organization, movement, response to stimuli, growth and development, excretion. Then we have is respiration, reproduction, nutrition, lifespan and death. Then we learn about the environment, the different two types of components, biotic components and abiotic components, in which we also learn about the parts, which are biotic components parts are plants, animals, scavengers and decomposers. And in abiotic we have light, temperature, air, water and soil. So friends, I hope that this video would be helpful to you in understanding the things around us. At the last, thanks for watching.